Greetings. Months ago, I made a video about Matthew 24:5. King James, "For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many." And I acknowledge that the classical and orthodox interpretation would read this to mean, "For many shall come in my name, saying, they are the Christ, and shall deceive many." And I had meditated on that verse multiple times. And then it occurred to me, if I wanted to warn someone about people coming who would make a certain declaration, I would refer to them as they. I would say they are. Let us look at an example. I want to warn you that people will come claiming that I am the butcher of Baghdad. To be crystal clear, they will be coming to say Texas is the butcher. I could make many clear and unambiguous declarative sentences. Men are coming who will call me the butcher of Baghdad. Men are coming who say I am the butcher of Baghdad. Men are coming who will say they speak for me and that I am the butcher of Baghdad. This is what I would say about other men who were coming and would claim that I, Texas 75023, am the butcher of Baghdad. Now take a moment and think. What would someone say if they were warning of others who would be coming, and the others would say of themselves that they are the butcher or butchers of Baghdad? Is there not one obvious, clear, and unambiguous way to say it? Men are coming who will say they speak for me and say they are the butcher of Baghdad. Think about that a moment. Because I think this sheds some real light on the meaning. If I wanted to be clear, I would say they are, and not say I am. So I began to look at the more than 20 translations on Biblos.com. Surely, in all the translators exploring the various ambiguities of the Greek language, one or two should explore the pronouns being used and choose they to make the translation clear. I looked, and there is not one translator who uses the pronoun they. Not one translator reads the ancient manuscript and translates it to mean a third-person personal pronoun. Now, I did find the Aramaic Bible in plain English to be rather interesting. "For many will come in my name, and they will say, I am the living God, the Messiah, and they will deceive many." But this is the only such extrapolation or difference in any of the translations. And I can see how the Mohammedan mind will view that one translation and read it that Christians who claim Jesus is the living God are the deceivers. And what comes to my mind is what Jesus said about telling parables. Matthew 13:11, "He answered and said unto them, Because it is given unto you to know the mysteries of the kingdom of heaven, but to them it is not given. For whosoever hath, to him shall be given, and he shall have more abundance. But whosoever hath not, from him shall it be taken away even that he hath. Therefore speak I to them in parables. Because they, seeing, see not, and hearing, they hear not, neither do they understand." Now, I would be the first to point out the direct meaning was hiding his teaching from the Jewish leaders of his day. That is certainly the most direct, obvious, and literal interpretation. But I think you need to consider the principle. So God had a choice. God could have told Jesus to say, "They are the Christ." And instead, Jesus said, "I am the Christ," using the first-person pronoun. But let's continue to examine this passage a little further, including the previous verse. Matthew 24:4, "And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many." That is twice in the same context Jesus warns against being deceived by some deception. Well, after years of studying, I would boldly declare deception is a pillar of Islam. Bold-faced lies repeated over and over. So Jesus, Prophet Isa to you who think you are Muslim, warns believers against the deceptive religion that calls Jesus the Christ, the Messiah, the Messiah. Christians, examine this verse, I beg you, and listen to the Spirit of God within you. I believe Jesus warned us of a deception that even claimed Jesus was the Christ. Brothers and sisters, Jesus mentioned deception twice. I believe that means it is important. Now, please follow along with me for one more minute. The classical and orthodox reading of this verse is that many would all wander around saying they are the Christ, right? Well, is that really going to actually deceive any believers? Are Christians going to be tricked and fooled by someone with no marks of crucifixion? By someone who can work no signs? When, by logical extension, this view requires many, dozens, even hundreds of such false claimants. Logically, you dismiss all but the most believable character, and even they will not be convincing. But remember, deception is subtle. The trick is to make it hard to detect. Claiming Jesus is the Messiah, but is only the Messiah and is only a prophet, a mere man, that is 9/10 the truth. The poison is the denial that Jesus is the Son of God and is one with God. Christians, wake up and realize that Jesus has warned us of the deception of Mohammedism. And if you call yourself Muslim, hear the word of God through Prophet Isa. Prophet Isa warned of the deception of Islam. You may heed Prophet Isa and leave the deception. This is your chance, O Muslim. If you have any respect for God, pray and ask God why Isa warned against the deceivers who would call Isa the Christ. Jesus has warned us, and he has warned you. Listen to Jesus, to Prophet Isa, and be not deceived by the false claim that Jesus is only the Christ, is only the Messiah, is only a man. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.